I'm no longer keeping these tips to myself. Get it? Here are the best Google Keep tips, mobile app edition. Hey friends, I'm Tasia Custode. Welcome back to my YouTube channel where I share tech tips, app reviews, and so much Google content that you'd think I'd own a stake in the company. Sadly, I do not. Today is all about Google Keep for mobile, where hopefully you'll learn some little known features you didn't even know existed. So let's go. All right, the Google Keep mobile app is available on iOS and Android, and these little known Google Keep tips work across both platforms. So if you're anything like me, you can talk a lot faster than you can tap with your thumbs. So first up, you can record and transcribe audio in Google Keep. Here's how. You'll have a little microphone icon near the bottom left of your Google Keep app. It's in the same spot on both Android and iOS, by the way. All you have to do is tap on the microphone, and if you haven't given the app permission to record audio, you'll allow permission. But other than that, you're going to just start talking. Google Keep will begin typing out what you're saying, and it does a pretty good job of transcribing the audio for you, period. So once you're done speaking, you'll now have a new note with everything you just said transcribed for you. So everything I just said is now in text form where I could easily copy and paste it if I needed to. Plus you'll have the actual recording itself underneath that you can play. And shout out to this hidden little accessibility feature. Say you're sharing a note with someone that has a hard time seeing the text on screen, now they can just play your note instead. Yes, please. You can also add a title to the note at the top, and then you can also add additional recordings by tapping the plus symbol in the bottom left, or if you don't need the recording at all, you can delete the recording by hitting the trash icon to the right of the recording. So this will just delete the voice recording, but will leave the transcribed note for you. How neat is that? All right, tip number two, add notes from other apps. So say you're in the Google app or Chrome or Twitter and you come across an article that you want to share either in its entirety or maybe sections of the article directly to Google Keep. Well, you can, and here's how. So first, if there is a bit of text that you want, just select the text, tap on share, and select Keep Notes if you're on Android. Here in this pop-up, you can title the note, then just tap on save. Now, if you're on iOS, it's pretty well the same steps. You'll select your text, tap share, and you'll find the Google Keep app, which might be buried in the more section. By the way, Keep Notes, Google Keep, it's all the same thing. It's actually different per platform. So on Android, it's the Keep Notes mobile app. On iOS, it's Google Keep mobile app. And on the web, it's Keep. I don't know why. Anyway, if you want to share an entire article or tweet or whatever, you can do that too. So instead of selecting text, you'll share the entire article to Google Keep. Your share icon may look a little bit different depending on whether or not you're on Android or iOS, but the exact same steps apply. And speaking of adding things to Google Keep, let's talk about tip number three, adding images. It is super easy to do because of course it is. So there are a couple of ways to add images to Google Keep. First, if you're already in a note, you can tap on that plus symbol in the bottom left of the screen. And from here, you can either take a photo, or if you already have a photo you want to add, you can tap on choose image. Then you'll just tap to add the image that you want. Now, if you're not in an existing note, you can still add an image. This time, tap on the little image icon near the bottom left. Conveniently, it's in the same spot on both Android and iOS. And then either take a photo or choose an image. This will add the image to a new note. And by the way, you can add multiple images to a Keep note as well. And while we're on the subject of images, tip number four is to annotate images. This is really helpful if you want to highlight a specific portion of your image. So if you tap on an image that's in your note, you'll be taken to a new screen where you'll have the paintbrush icon near the top right. Simply tap on that icon in order to annotate the image. Along the bottom, you'll have different options for pen color and size. So there's a pen option with a bunch of colors, a marker option, and a highlight option. And by the way, to access these colors or widths, you just tap again on that option. But once you've chosen that, you can start drawing on your image. If you want to erase an annotation, you can just tap on the eraser icon on the bottom and then tap on an annotation to delete it. Or you can clear all the annotations at once. Now you may have noticed in the bottom left, there is a little selection tool. If you tap on that and then tap on an annotation, you can actually drag that annotation wherever you want on your image, and you can also resize it too. Just tap off of the annotation to set it in that place. And yes, this functions the exact same on iOS and Android. And tip number 5 is the last one I'll cover when it comes to images. You can actually convert an image to text. So think, for example, you've taken a handwritten note or list, you can actually convert that to a digital note or list. How cool is that? All right, so we learned how to upload an image or take an image and add it to keep. So I've added an image of a little handwritten to-do list that I made, and now I want to turn this into editable text in Google Keep, rather than an image of my to-do list. I'll tap on the image to select it, and this time I'll tap on the three-dot menu icon near the top right. From here, I'm gonna select Grab Image Text. Now this should happen right away for you, but depending on how much text is in the image or what type of image it is, the processing time could vary a little bit, because this works on any image with text. So this could be a street sign, a picture of a poster, or a picture of a note you took. Any image that has text. But either way, the text will be extracted from the image and placed underneath it in the Keep note. So once again, now that it's editable as text in Google Keep, you could copy and paste this however you see fit. It does a pretty good job of grabbing that text, but it may not be perfect. So just keep an eye on any errors and just edit it as needed. And before we pop on over to tip number 6, if you're liking this video so far, go ahead and give it a like, and remember to subscribe to my channel for more content just like this. And now, tip number 6. You can set time and place reminders. This is so helpful if you are forgetful like I am. No judgment. So from a note in Google Keep, you have a little bell icon near the top right. It's in the middle option here. If you tap on that, you'll have a ton of reminder options to choose from. In fact, if you have home and work addresses set in Google Maps, it's gonna pull those automatically for you. But the important thing here is that you can pick an automatic time, or you can select pick a date and time to customize the date and time. And you can even select if this is a repeating reminder or not. And you'll just tap on save to save the date and time reminder. And what's really great about this is that the reminder is automatically added to your Google Calendar. But you can also set a reminder based on location. And to be clear, you have to pick time and date or location reminder. You can't do both at the same time. Now, here is where your screen might differ a little bit depending on whether you're on Android or iOS, but the exact same functions are available. So if you're on Android and you selected the customized date and time, this is where you can also pick a place. It's from this same pop-up here. And you'll notice that your home and work locations are there for you if you've got those set in Maps. Or you can add a location of your choosing. Once you're done, you're gonna tap on save and your location reminder will be all set, as long as you've allowed those permissions in the app. Now, if you're on iOS, your date and time and place are two different selections. So from that reminder bell, this time tap on pick place, and you can add your location and tap the check mark to save that location reminder. Again, in order for this to work, you're gonna have to allow that permission in the Google Keep app, because then it's gonna use your location to automatically send you a reminder when you get near that spot. So once that location reminder is set, you're going to get that notification when you get near or to that specific spot. So think about how helpful this would be for shopping lists, for example. And now we've come to, what is this? Google Keep tip number 7. Sure, let's go with that. You can switch your app to dark mode if you're on, I believe, Android Lollipop or later. Sorry, my fellow iOS users, but if you are on Android, this can help make the app a little easier on your eyes. So from the Keep app, tap on the hamburger menu in the top left, then tap on settings, and from here tap on theme, and simply toggle on dark mode. It's that easy. By the way, if you want a comprehensive video on how to use Google Keep, I have linked to that in the description below, or you can click somewhere up here for that as well. That's it. We officially made it through my favorite Google Keep mobile app tips. So those are my picks for the best Google Keep tips for mobile. And now I want to hear from you. What are your favorite Google Keep tips and why? Let everyone know in the comments below. As always, thank you so much for watching. If you like this video, well, I want to know. So give it a like, a share, or leave that comment below. You can click right about here to subscribe to my channel, and here for even more Google Keep content. Thanks for watching. See you next time. Google Keep tips. Google Keep tips. Google Keep tips. Whew. Say that 10 times fast.